We just got done restoring this car. It's a beautiful car. It's a car that took us a little over a year to do. Now, we got two problems on this car. I went over one of them with you. And if you look down here, you can see where the mechanic shop dropped the car off the lift. Right here on this door. So we got to paint that whole rocker panel. I still got to adjust the door. I got to paint the inside of the jam, of course. But, so the mechanic shop dropped the car off the lift. They didn't do the mechanic work that they were paid to do. There's no air conditioning in the car. The car runs like shit, am I right?
Yes.
What does the car do? With a brand new motor.
Has a bang in it.
Has a banging noise and a knocking noise in it. They didn't fix that. And then what they did is they dropped the car on the lift. Made it worse. You can see where I took my DA sander right here. Look at this. And I have went down to bare metal. Now, I thought that possibly the mechanic shop poured some fluids on it and made it wrinkle, but I'm going to tell you what the problem is. This is called piss poor prep job. This is what happens when you don't know what the f*** you're doing. Now, I hired this f***ing loser as a helping hand. I helped him out. He was looking for a job. He claimed he knew how to do bodywork. He claimed he knew how to do all this. I hired the guy. And this is what he f***ing leaves me right here. Am I right or wrong? Yes or no?
Yep.
All right. If you think there's money in painting these cars, you're f***ing crazy. I have to paint this whole front end over because of one f***ing mistake. And the mistake is, it wasn't f***ing prepped right.
Welcome to D.I.Y. Automotive School with my friend Pete and Minnie, the body shop girl. It's everything you need to know about cars and more.
Trusted the loser that I hired to do this job, and he f***ed me in my ass. And this is a good lesson out there for employees. If you own your own business, I'm going to tell you right now, finding good employees in today's society, it's gone. Because the only thing these loser-ass people want to do is sit on their ass and figure out how they can make money on the internet or sitting on their ass. Am I right? Nobody wants to work for a fucking living anymore. And when they do come over to work, this is the kind of shit you get. Can you focus in on that and look at that? Can you see those little spots on there?
Yes.
Now we're going to walk over because when I restore a car, I do it to the fullest high quality restoration that I can possibly do. We're going to walk over and look at another car, and I'm going to basically walk through what I did to this car to get it to where it's at. So if we come into this bay here, we're looking at a 1976 Vega station wagon. Now you can see all the bodywork's basically been done. I got to go back over it one more time. There's a few little flaws in it. It's been 2K primed and it's basically ready to go back over and do the bodywork, spot prime it, and paint it. Am I right, Minnie?
Yes.
It took me close to 3, 4, 5 months off and on to do all the bodywork on this car. We had major hail damage up here. If you can bring the camera up here. There you go. Thank you, Minnie, the body shop girl, camera girl, Minnie. Major hail damage up here. And then swing the camera on down here. The car was hit real hard in this area. I still got to do a little bit of bodywork right here, but it came out really nice for the first go around. We had hail damage from that front fender over there. Can you see my hand? There it is. Front fender right there, all the way down. Follow my finger, please. Come on, go, go, go. All the way down to here. The car was riddled with hail damage. It had minor dents on it, which is common on a car like this. Throwaway car that it is. This is a throwaway car. I want everybody to know that. This car was not intended to be restored. And we got a couple little imperfections right here on this body line. You can't see them in the camera, but I can see them. Let me get my pencil out right here since I'm... Do you see what I got here? I got a pencil, so when I walk past the car, I know where the imperfections are on it. If we walk down the road here, you can already see where I penciled it right here. Okay, there's a mark there. So I keep this pencil in my pocket, so when I walk past the car and I see an imperfection on it, I can circle it because, you know, sometimes you got to use the light that you have up above to find these things as shadows. And then if we walk over here, this is where it all starts. What we have done to this car, we have stripped this down to bare metal by using soda blasting. Soda blasting is the only way to strip a car down to bare metal because if you notice, this car is still in bare metal. It's been sitting here for over a month. There's no rust on it except the surface rust that was originally on it before we had it soda blasted. It's in good shape and it's ready to do the bodywork. But the problem you have, look at this right here. Does that look familiar? Does that look familiar, what I just showed you? On the fucking Mustang over there, does it? I see little spots and little imperfections. And that is caused by poor prep job work. Now, I hired this clown act piece of shit over here to help me restore cars, and this is how he pays me, because he said he was quote unquote Mr. Professional, been doing it for 25 fucking years. I got my own fucking tools. The only one that I can trust to do this kind of work is myself, me, because I know if I do it, it's gonna be done right, because I know I'm the only person that's gonna go back and redo his fucking mistake. I don't see him here offering any help. I haven't heard from this jackass for a year. The last time I talked to this fucking loser, I basically kicked him off my property because of that reason. He's a fucking loser. But out of the goodness of my heart, being my friend Pete that I am, I took him under my wing and I hired him to work on a $30,000, $40,000, $50,000 car when it's completely done. How many times has this fucking happened to me? Not just by this clown fuck, but by basically every fucking employee that I've ever hired. How many times? Go ahead, tell us. How many times, Minnie?
I don't know, Pete. I'm not gonna be talked to like that.
How many times has this happened with people that have worked on cars and have been over to my shop working, and I and you are the ones that have to fix their problem? How many times? Can you answer that? Is it over 10?
I don't know, Pete.
15, 20, 37.
Well, why don't you quit being such a Mr. Nice Guy and hiring all these fucking losers? Don't you learn from your
That's
own
what
mistakes?
Happens. That's
don't
what
you
happens.
Learn from your own fucking mistakes.
You look past the bad and you find the good in people.
Bullshit.
You help them out.
Not
and this
you're...
is the way they repay you.
Not...
They spit on you when they fucking leave.
Not when you're trying to run a business, Pete.
Look over here.
Your business is not a fucking charity.
Come on over here. Come on over
your
here.
Your business is not a charity.
Come on over here.
I've been telling you that for years, but you don't listen to me.
Do you see something that looks familiar over here? Can you bring that camera over here, please? Look what we got. Does that look familiar?
Yeah, and who takes the brunt of the fucking punishment? Huh?
Now.
I want all y'all to know out there, I'm the one that takes the brunt of the fucking punishment when Pete gets pissed.
Okay, I'm not hollering at you. I'm not fucking hollering.
But you do all the time.
No, I
Pete.
Don't
lie.
I'm hollering in the wind. I'm hollering at the walls.
Yeah.
I'm hollering at the cocksucker that isn't here doing this.
Yeah, and there are people that have been here to see
now,
me, so.
The moral of this story is, if you plan on opening a shop or you plan on doing work for other people, you better watch your fucking ass, because this is the shit that happens right here.
Listen to your wife.
This is the shit that happens right here. When you...
She has your best interest.
When you are in the driver's seat of that classic automobile and it's your responsibility to deliver that car to that person that paid all that fucking money, you're the one that's going to have to redo all this. Not your lame-brained bullshit loser employee that you hired because you felt sorry for him or he's one of your best buddies and he needs a couple bucks in his pocket. If you're an upstanding, honest business person, this is the shit that happens to you right here. I've seen more crooked, more conniving, chiseling body shops make hundreds and thousands of millions of dollars and get away with it. They get away with keeping your money, and guys like me, girls like me, that are honest and faithful and dedicated are the ones that fucking get fucked. So, I gotta paint both fenders, I gotta paint the hood over, we gotta get that rocker panel painted. Let me tell you about the rocker panel. The insurance company doesn't want to pay me full price to fix the fucking rocker panel. They told me, fuck off. We're not paying your prices. We don't give a shit about you. You're a loser. Fuck you. This is how much we're paying. Fuck off. Take it up with the owner on the rest of the money. Because the insurance company's the big man. You gonna go hire a fucking lawyer? Are you gonna sue the insurance company for the measly little change that they're gonna owe you to finish the job? Compared to the billions of dollars they have in their bank account? That's why they're billionaires. Because they're right in the same fucking conniving fucking category as that loser body shop I just talked about. They screw you, they fuck you, and this is the situation you got when you hire some loser-ass piece of shit that you feel sorry for. I got this fender almost done. How's yours looking?
It's not. I'm holding the fucking camera.
Let me get back to work here. And I want everybody out there to think about this, because I think my friend Pete's getting out of painting fucking cars. I think that's what I ought to do. I think I ought to just do body work. I ought to go ahead and do metal fabrication. Put it in primer, paint ready, take your car, go somewhere else, and let somebody else be responsible.
Because of that shit.
I remember when we used to have a shop that had 5 employees, and we used to be productive, and we used to make money. All them people are dead and gone or retired now. You can't hire nobody to do this. I put a fucking ad in the Dallas Morning News. This was how many years ago? 15? 12?
Longer than that.
I put a fucking ad in the paper. In the ad, I specifically stated, no drugs, no alcohol, professional help only in capital letters. One fucking guy came over, and let me tell you who that fucking guy was. It was the father of his son that just got out of prison from fucking going to prison for drugs. And asked me about hiring, that he saw my ad, and if I can teach him how to do this. You are fucking shitting me.
Well, that just goes to show a parent will do anything for their child.
You're fucking shitting me. It specifically states in the ad, professional help only, no alcohol, no drugs. And the only person that shows up, well, I'm sorry, 2 people showed up. I had one guy that wanted $55 an hour. I told him, go fuck off.
All right, are you through ranting so that we can get back to work?
I'm already working. I got a lot of shit to do here.
Then I'm just going to turn the camera off now.
That might be a good idea because I might start cussing in a minute. I'm sorry, before we leave, Nitpick Norm decided to walk in on us. What's going on?
Oh, nothing.
Okay. You own your own company, right?
Yep.
You own your own business?
Yes.
You said that you hired a guy just recently. A colleague of ours called you and said that his friend needed a job badly, so you went ahead and broke down and hired him. How long did he last on the job?
2 hours.
2 hours. And didn't you say he threw up all over the place?
He didn't throw up, but he was ready to pass out.
I
can't do this, man. I can't.
Too hard work. It's too hard. I need to go back to the gas pipe and sit down and sell marijuana pipes and bombs because this work's too hard. Isn't that basically what
it
was?
That's
yeah,
it.
Exactly. Look what our fucking buddy did to us. What are you thinking about this mess here?
Well,
Norm,
I'm going to tell you the truth, Pete. The first time I saw him, I told you, get him out of here.
Yeah, well, let me tell you something here. And you're a good example, okay? When you hire people because you feel sorry for them, and you want to teach them how to do it, what happens, Norm?
They screw you up.
But you do that every time, Pete. You do that every time. You never learn from your own fucking mistakes.
Thank you, man.
So what does that make me?
Girl, I wasn't actually talking to you.
An idiot?
I wasn't actually talking to you.
Ignorant?
I was talking to another business owner over here that has experience in it.
Yeah. And there again, you never listen to your wife, so, karma.
So I'm stuck with painting this whole fucking front end. Because he didn't prep the metal properly, like he claimed he knew how to do. This isn't the first time, Norm. I've had about 27 fucking people over here like this guy. You've seen about 18 of them.
Yep, they're beauties.
Yeah. Thank you for your input, Norm. You didn't really give us any input.
Well, what do you want me to say? I told you he was a loser when I saw him the first time.
Yeah. Let me ask you a question, though. What's going on with your fucking car outside here in the front? What is this deal?
Well, that's Garrett's.
Hold on. Well, this thing right here.
That's Garrett's.
Yeah, what's going on with that? What do we do with this beast?
He is making it a rat rod. He's putting in a 5.7 or 5.9 heavy. I don't know which one. Modern heavy and drivetrain.
Huh. You think he'll ever have it done?
Who knows?
Now, Garrett's your son. We're going to get a talk with him on this. My angle is he's got too many little projects going on. He's a tinker toy guy, and it'll probably take him 20 years to even accomplish getting this done. And by that time, the motor and tranny that he has will be old school.
Probably so.
Yeah. Did he already order his whale tail fin?
No.
His super bird fin he's putting on it? Not yet?
No.
But he's going to do that.
He's making it a
Joe Dirt. It's a Joe Dirt car. Yeah. Great. Yeah.
Beautiful.
Yeah, that's a good. What is this? A 71? 70?
70 Roadrunner.
70 Roadrunner. Wow. Just another fucking example that Mopar freaks will go to the extreme to fucking do whatever it takes to put a Mopar on the road and say, I'm the best. Yeah, real nice, Norm. Real fucking nice. If that was my car, I'd put it on Craigslist and sell for about $7,000.
That's what I would have done, too.
How much is that car worth, Norm?
Probably $5,000-$6,000.
$5,000 or $6,000, just like it sits.
Yep.
That thing already, that would have been sold yesterday, dude.
It was a 383 four-speed car. It has the fender tag and all.
We got to go, Norm. I got a lot of work to do.
All
okay,
right.
I don't give a shit about specs on a fucking Mopar.
Okay.
I got my side done. Many of the body shop girls working on her side. And hopefully this little fiasco will be over with. Did you see what's going on over here, Norm? See where I had the DA sander through the metal? That's where the paint was blistering and peeling.
Right.
I thought it was from the mechanic shop. But you know, since I'm an honest fucking guy, I'm not blaming it on them. It's my fault. It's Southwest Riding Customs fault that we gotta fucking fix.
I saw it. It was blistering. I saw it.
How you looking over there, Minnie? Is it getting done?
Yeah.
Huh?
Yes, Pete.
Yeah. Thank you.
watching D.I.Y. Automotive School. Classes don't stop till you know everything.